Netflix is the leader of its clan for video streaming. And for all tech savvies, this market giant has revealed that Python is the secret to its success. So welcome back, guys. Here is Vajiha from Edureka with all the interesting information about how Netflix uses Python. Before we begin, just make sure you subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon to stay updated with all the latest Edureka videos. Coming back towards this session, let's first begin with a small introduction to Netflix, and then we shall move on to see how Netflix uses Python in various sectors, such as for its CDN, which is Open Connect, for demand engineering and machine learning, big data analytics and scientific experimentations, video encoding, animations, security, and finally for monitoring and auto-remediation. So without any further delays, let's get started. Netflix, as we all know, is an American company which renders video on demand services. It has about 148 million subscribers throughout the world, and the number, however, keeps growing each day. In a period of approximately 2 decades, Netflix has emerged as the king of its clan for the biggest TV series and movies throughout the world. Being the fastest growing brand of America and having a revenue of $20.5 billion till June 2019, it's enough for it to be an eye-catcher, thereby interesting all into its technical spheres. Let's move on to see how Netflix uses Python in its various domains. Engineers at Netflix admit that they use Python for the full content lifecycle, from deciding which content to fund all the way to operating the CDN that serves the final video to 148 million subscribers. Now that we've taken the name of CDN over here, let's move on to see what this is and how it makes use of Python. The CDN or content delivery network that Netflix makes use of is Open Connect. This basically comes into picture when you hit the play button. All the content delivered to the end user is looked after by this CDN. Open Connect basically requires various other softwares to design, build, and operate it, which are in turn written in Python. Not just this, the network devices underlying this CDN are Python applications, since Python is prominent in solving network issues. Now that we are aware of the first component, Open Connect, let's move on to see how Netflix uses Python for its demand engineering. The demand engineering team is responsible for handling Netflix Cloud's regional failovers, traffic administration, capacity operations management, which is looking after the limit up to which the content can be made serviceable, and fleet efficiency. The libraries used by this team are the NumPy and the SciPy library, which is used for performing numerical analysis, Boto3, which is the software development kit of the Amazon Web Services for Python. This helps Python developers integrate Python into AWS, thereby allowing development in the infrastructure. RedisQ or RQ, which is a Python library which helps to keep track of the tasks that are present in the queue and allows their execution, thereby allowing the management of asynchronous workloads. Flask. Netflix uses Flask for Python web development. Netflix uses Flask APIs to bind all of the previous segments together. Not just this, Netflix also makes use of Jupyter Notebooks along with Interact, which is an extension for Jupyter, on a large scale. Jupyter is known to be popular for data analysis. It serves very well in operation data analysis and visualization, which in turn help in detecting capacity regressions. Now let's move on to see how Python is used for machine learning. Machine learning ranges from creating personalization algorithms to figuring out the use cases. Personalization algorithms help to train the machine learning models as per the Netflix standard. It also provides personalized recommendations, outlines on a day-to-day basis, label generations, etc. The libraries required to learn deep neural networks are TensorFlow, Keras, and PyTorch, whereas XGBoost and LightGBM for gradient-boosted decision trees. Netflix has also developed quite a few higher-level libraries that help in combining with the work areas such as fact logging, feature extraction, publishing, etc. Apart from all this, Netflix also makes use of MetaFlow to create machine learning projects. The big data team is responsible to execute the ETL or the extract, transform, load, and ad hoc pipelines. A major part of this orchestration is written in Python. This team uses a scheduler which runs on Jupyter Notebooks with Papermill to produce job types with templates, for example, Spark, Presto, etc. In addition to this, the team has also created an event-driven platform which is built completely on Python, They've created a number of events and combined it into a single one, allowing Netflix to filter, react, and route events. Okay, so now let's move on to see how Python is used for scientific experimentations. This platform is basically created for experimentations and to allow A/B testing. Guys, A/B testing is also called as split testing, and it deals with comparing two versions and figuring out the better performing variation among them. The scientific experimentation team can also present new innovations in data, statistics, and visualization. The Python framework that is implemented here is Metrics Repo, which is based on Pypika and allows writing of reusable parameterized queries. For the statistics sector, PyArrow and RPY2 are used to calculate the statistics in either Python or R. Plotly helps in visualizations. Video encoding or media cloud engineering. This team is responsible for encoding and re-encoding tasks for the Netflix catalog. Python is used approximately for 50 projects such as the VMAF, which is Video Multi-Method Assessment Fusion, and Mezzanine File System, Computer Vision Solution, which deals with imagery using Archer, etc. Netflix Animation and NVFX. Python forms the base for all animations and visual effects at Netflix. Maya and Nuke, which are 3D and 2D computer graphic applications, are united using Python. Now let's move on to see how Netflix uses Python for its information security. Netflix uses Python-powered information systems for auto-remediation, security automation, risk classifications, etc. The most active open-source project of this team is Security Monkey. Netflix also uses BLESS, which stands for Bastion's Lambda Mferl SSH service to protect secure shell resources. RepoKid is used to grant IAM permissions, and TLS certificates are allotted through Lemur. Both of these tasks rely mainly on Python. Finally, let's move on to see how Python is used for monitoring and auto-remediation. The monitoring and auto-remediation team is also known as Insight Engineering Team. They build and execute tools for operational insight, diagnostics, auto-remediation, and altering. For most of its services, this team makes use of Python. For example, the Spectator Python Client Library. This library is used for recording dimensional time series. Along with these libraries, products like Winston and Bolt are also built on Python frameworks, which are Flask, Unicorn, and Flask REST Plus. Summing it all up, one can easily claim that Python is the driving force for Netflix. With this, we've reached the end of this session. I hope you've enjoyed and learned something new. In case you have any queries or suggestions, please do let me know in the comment section and I will revert to you at the earliest. Goodbye and take care.
I hope you have enjoyed listening to this video. Please be kind enough to like it, and you can comment any of your doubts and queries and we will reply them at the earliest. Do look out for more videos in our playlist and subscribe to Edureka channel to learn more. Happy learning!